Should we delete them?
Yes.
They have to make a rule. So do we really want to leave all these students without teacher? You registered into it, so you are going to delete everything, especially with that man or woman. So it's not, so if you select that, that's what you're going to do. All right? So cascade update related. So if I change faculty's ID number, or if I change student's ID number, should I update that information? Cascade update, cascade delete, that's what they mean. And from internal control point of view, you should always look for this enforced referential integrity. If I don't, look what happens. I do not see one and infinity sign. So if you have this relationship, it's possible to have a course section without professor. Okay? So you are an auditor, you are responsible for internal control, right? Here is a system which provides all that internal control. 1, 2, 3. Should we have an order without a customer? Should we have an employee without department?
No.
You know. Or should we have a secretary for a department without department? So, edit relationship and enforce referential integrity. I'm doing right click, all right? So now, left click, course number to section course, section CRS. Again, is it possible to register? Is it possible to create a section without a course? Course should be listed in the catalog, right? If you do not have it, there's a problem. So that's what we do. That's the relationship. And as an auditor, find the relationships, whether they are required. This referential integrity is a key. All right? And imagine one of them is faculty. This was customer. This was the orders. Should you have that cascade update and cascade delete? You lose your customer. You are not, this customer is no good anymore. I don't want that. And I don't want to deal with that. So what should I do with the orders that customer has? If I delete, what will happen? All the money he owes us will disappear. So you don't do that, customer. That cascade update, cascade delete is scary. Watch out. So we create the relationship, we save it, and I go back to query creation, create query in the design form, right? And select the fields you want, course, enrollment, faculty, and section, and student, all right? Then close this thing, and then put the student over here. I want to see the same picture. So, course at the top, faculty at the bottom, section, and enrollment, okay. So, now I want to create a query. I don't know which fields I will use. I have no idea. So what I want to do is, first thing, select all the fields from parent tables. So student is a parent table, right? I highlight all of them. What you do, click on the first one, and shift and down. And grab them, and release it here. Notice all of the fields are copied down here. And let's go to course, highlight all of those fields, and do it again. Faculty, these are parent tables. They are at the top level. Okay? So, it keeps going on. And when it comes to section, be careful. Section has a section professor and section course number. Right? They are already copied from the other two tables. So I don't want them copied down here one more time. They are foreign key here. So foreign keys should be excluded from query. Otherwise, you will have a bunch of weird results. So CRN number was not there. I'm going to do that. And I'm going to put section dates, and section room, and section end. Right? Notice I am ignoring section professor and section dates. And when it comes to enrollment, what should I copy?
We need a credit?
Just student credit, right? Mm-hmm. Because all the others are already in my system. Alright? Right there. When you are done, you say run. What happened is now computer went through all of those tables, merged all of them, and they put them together. So you can say, if you want to see student number, let's sort it with student sort. All right? Student number 3, his name is Mays, right? And what course is he registered into? He is registered into accounting 3354, accounting 4355, 4247. All right? And I can see, let's say, student number 10. He is registered into 3 courses, okay? So, and I can see, let's see, what's the name of the course? 4247, auditing, right? And the course is listed for 3 credits, but this guy is registered for 2 credits. And professor for this course is me, right? And my faculty extension, 2345. Highest degree is PhD. And course starts at 9 o'clock, Tuesdays and Fridays. Okay? So everything is mixed up here, but it's not very useful. So what we want is, we want to little strip where students can see which course they registered into, and how many, what the course is, what the professor is, but when the course starts. All right? So what I want here is, so I leave this here, exit, give a name. The system says query 2, all right. I call it query 2. Okay. Now we go to creating report. And report, the best one is to create a report is wizard. Is everybody with me or just am I going too fast? Some people are not following, but you watch it and then you can send that video. How's that?
Okay.
Send me one too, so I can send all of them. Okay.
All right. I'll send it to you.
So we are going to create a report through wizard. Wizard is the easy one. And again, system warns there's a possibility of virus. We know that. All right? And what you should do is you find the query you created. Query number 2 at the bottom. And at this point, you should think about what kind of report you want. in this report, I want student ID. I don't need his name. For the time being, I don't, okay? And in that report, I should have the CRN number, right? And start time, or date, let's call it date. And start time. I don't care anything else. I can add them later on. So what we do is we select student number, where is that thing? Oh, query two, and student ID is name of the student number. And find CRN number. Here. And what I need is date. Do we have date? I don't think I have date here. Oh, the section date is right there. All right. And section start. And section room. I think you should know when the course starts and which room it's in. All right. So I go next. Look what happened now. Computer automatically know that I'm going to group it by student. All right. And inside that report, I'm going to have the courses he's registered. All right. And then all that information. Let's do that. And you say next. If you need any other grouping, it's possible. So next, and is there any order? So, I don't know, section start should be, date and start should be the first ones. Student should know. Starting time and the section time. Let's go that way. And I usually select landscape and outline. Holds the paper sidewise. So you won't run out of space. All right. And next. And I call this raster. No, registration, right? Registration. Registration for students and finish it. Student number three registered into CRN number is here. All right. And this class starts at 12:15 and it's in St. John's Hall 209, all that information. So I can cut this to and give it to the students if I want. I can email it. I can have a page break in between. So can that ID number three does not really make sense to me. Who's the number three? Who knows? I'd like to know who that is. So I have to modify this report. So we created this report and we are not happy with the appearance. So what I'm going to do is now save this, all right? Close print preview, save this file. Oops, not file, I'm sorry. Okay. So, all right, we have created registration for students. Right? And I like to have this CRN number as the first column. And I like to add